AI content is slowly killing itself. By using its own old content to inform new content, AI models are accepting less and less accurate information to output answers. The culprit? The very information that the models previously put out. While an original piece of content might have a very small amount of error, that information will be taken as fact by a newer AI model. Each time this happens, the errors will multiply. Does this spell the end of AI models as we know it? No, and let me explain why. But first, let's dig into how AI is cannibalizing itself. Since the birth of ChatGPT, AI models have become readily available to the average person. The content that those models have produced is now all over the internet. How do researchers know that AI models are poisoning their later content? Well, start with some set of human-produced information. In one case, researchers focused on the history of English architecture. Then have an AI language model produce some content based on that input. Repeat that process using the previous model's output for the next model's input. By the 10th cycle, the researchers saw the AI model talking about jackrabbits, something totally unrelated to English architecture. According to one machine learning researcher at the University of Oxford, it gets to a point where your model is practically meaningless. The researchers tested a wide range of models, from simplistic ones to incredibly complex ones, and the outcome was the same. In their words, they witnessed total model collapse. They even tested image models like DALL-E and Midjourney, and after three generations, their original images of flowers had devolved into abstract blurs. Beyond just giving clearly unrelated and unhelpful content, AI models will also become more prone to bias over time in these recursive cycles. If they exclude a marginalized group, fact, or piece of information, then subsequent models will double down on that exclusion. Model collapse and bias are both serious concerns for those who use AI models. The adoption of AI models like ChatGPT was so fast and widespread that there wasn't much time to reckon with these types of consequences. AI-generated content is already proliferating the internet with information that newer models will use. Even mainstream news outlets have begun publishing AI-generated articles, and some Wikipedia editors want to use language models to produce content for the site. So, to prevent this self-cannibalization, AI models will have to learn how to differentiate from human-generated and AI-generated content. That's easier said than done. For example, it'd be easiest to just look at internet content that predated AI's adoption and use them as informational inputs into AI models. The obvious problem is that all the data becomes more outdated over time. That means the solution has to be direct. AI models must be able to differentiate between AI and human content. Right now, they can't do that very well. There are some AI models that can do that in very specific niches, like, for example, in academic papers, but a model that can scan the entire internet from content written by thousands of different AI models, that's much harder to achieve. OpenAI, the creators of ChatGPT, have a tool called Classifier, which can supposedly tell the difference between human and AI content. But it only has a success rate of 26%. There is hope, however, that this self-cannibalization can be stopped before it becomes a huge problem. Generative AI came way sooner than anyone expected. So too might the solution for its own poisoning. It's within the realm of reason that some model or program could be developed to analyze for AI-generated content before any of our earliest estimates. Only then could total model collapse be avoided.